Nowadays, marketers need to share all kinds of content every day, from PDFs to images, all the way to videos to communicate internally with their team and colleagues, or externally with clients or business partners. There are two main reasons to share content. The first is to deliver content to someone who needs to use it. In our case, we would provide them with a link to download whichever files they need. And the second is to collaborate on content either internally or with an external business partner, like an agency. In this case, we would give them a view share link that will open our in-browser high-resolution content viewer. Being able to easily share content with different stakeholders you're working with will make your life as a marketer a lot less stressful. And you're in luck. You can do just that within DALIM ES. Sounds interesting? Awesome. In that case, this is how you can share content in DALIM ES. We'll take a look at the two different types of share links we can create, what different options we can set when creating our share link, and finally, we will create both a view link and a download link together. First things first, we need to select the content we want to share. So simply click on the file or use shift click to select multiple files. You'll then see a menu appear on the left of your screen. Click on the share icon of that menu and a new window will pop up on your screen. As mentioned before, there are two types of shares we can create, download and view. We can select which type from the share type drop-down menu. Let's start with a view share. There are several options we can set to our share link. The first is an expiration date. You can set a date at which your share link will expire and make the content you are sharing inaccessible. By default, the use default expiry option is selected. We have set our default expiry to unlimited, so the link will never expire unless we define a date. The view as field lets you set a username for the user you are sharing your content to. This can be one of the pre-existing users in DALIM ES or a guest user you can create by adding a new email. Let's say you're working with a marketing agency to plan out a new campaign and you have content that you want to share with them. Let's give them an email address like marketing@agency.com, which will be the email address and username we see when they write annotations. This helps to avoid any confusion when working with a team of people. If you leave this field blank, then we will just see the email address we sent our share link to as the author of those annotations. This brings us to the send to field. As with any email, this is where we are going to add our share link recipients. When you click on the field, a list of all the DALIM ES users will drop down, and all you have to do is click on the person you are going to send your share link to. And of course, if you are sending your content to someone externally, you can simply write their email address in this line. Below, you will find a subject line to give a title to the email you will send, along with a text area below that to write a message. Once you've done that, simply click the send icon at the bottom right of your screen, and the system will send the email. Now that we've seen how it works for view share links, let's see what it looks like when we want to share a downloadable file. As you can tell, nothing much changes other than the fact that there is no view as field here, which makes sense because once someone clicks on the link, the content will then be downloaded. So just as before, set an expiration date or use your default expiration date. List the contacts you want to send your share link to, write a subject for your email, a quick word about what you are sending them, and hit the send button below. But wait, there's more. You might have noticed that before I filled in the send to line, there was a row of icons at the bottom of our pop-up window. This is where we can choose different ways to share our share link. And as we aren't sending an email to a recipient, it is important to give a name in the view as field to help keep track of who is who. So, starting from the left, the first icon copies your share link to your clipboard. This is a quick solution if you need a colleague's opinion by sending him a link quickly over Slack or any other instant messaging tool. The second icon with an envelope will open your default email application on your computer if you'd rather send your share link from your personal address instead of through DALIM ES. Last but not least are three icons to share your content via Twitter, Facebook, or LinkedIn respectively. Oh, and also one more thing before I forget. If you're trying to find the share link of an old file you sent a while ago, you don't have to go rummaging through your old emails or messages. Simply open the share window and navigate to the Your Shares tab. And there you will find a list of all your shared links, and you can copy them to your clipboard or even delete them. Let's quickly recap. To share content in DALIM ES, you need to select the files you wish to share, click the share icon to open up the share window, select if you want to share a view or a download share link, set an expiration date, give a name in the View As field if you are sharing a view link, fill in the recipients of your share link, write a subject line and a message, hit send or use one of the buttons at the bottom of the window to share your content. And that is how you can share content in DALIM ES. Oh, I've just been told that there are some other videos you can check out. They're also just as great as this one, apparently. You can go watch them by clicking any of the links around my head here somewhere. And if not, just subscribe to the channel, and then you can see any of the future videos that will come out soon.